Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we're going to learn a concept that is FCFE, that is free cash flow from the firm equity. Calculation of the free cash flow to equity, you know, we'll be learning some of the formula and example. Let's begin. Now, free cash flow to the equity model is one of the discounted DCF approaches, okay, along with the FCFF to calculate the fair price of the stock. Now, FCFE measure, you know, how much the cash a firm can return to its shareholders and is calculated after taking care of the taxes, the Capex, you can say, and the debt cash flows. Okay. Now, in addition, that FCFE model is very similar to DDM or dividend discount model, which directly calculates the equity value of the firm. Unfortunately, FCFE model has various limitations like dividend discount model. For example, it is useful only in cases where the company's leverage is not more volatile in nature, and it cannot be applied to the companies with changing debt leverage. Now, FCFE formula goes something like this. FCFE is equal to your net income. You need to add something over here as depreciation plus any changes in the working capital, and then post you need to add any net borrowings or the net debt. Once you do that, you have your answer. The first that we are going to discuss is the net income. See, net income is after the payment of the interest and expense. Okay. Net income can be taken directly from the income statement. You can also find this in the cash flow statement. Cash flow from the operation in the CFO is prepared using the indirect method. The second thing, you need to add back any depreciation. So add any depreciation and amortization. Now, when we are talking about this, amortization head is not given separately of this expenses and gets included in the SG&A. You can find depreciation and amortization from the cash flow from the operations. The third thing that you need to do is plus or minus, you can say, you need to add or less any changes in the working capital. Okay, so you need to note something that in cash can be either outflow or inflow. Working capital primarily includes inventory, receivables, payables, and you may also include accrued liabilities in this formula. Short-term debt is not included here in the changes in the working capital. Now, the fourth is you will deduct something that is called Capex. Capex over here, see, critical to determine Capex level requires to support sales and margins to forecast. This numbers can be most easily be located from the cash flow from the investments. You need to note that not only the capital expenditure is taken, we must also include the addition to the intangible assets. Intangible becomes important for software knowledge-based businesses. Fifth, what you need to do, you need to just add or deduct, that is add or less any net borrowings or the net debts. Talking about this, like working capital, this number can also be in outflow or inflow. This includes both the short term as well as the long term debt. And be sure to include the net figures, that is debt issued minus the debt repaid. So your FCFE formula goes something like this, is equal to EBIT, EBIT, minus your interest, okay, interest less taxes from this, and you will add any depreciation plus amortization and changes in the working capital. You will add something that is called Capex plus any net debt, that is net borrowings, right? And FCFF can also be calculated as the FCFF less any interest into 1 minus tax. Okay. You need to add the net borrowings from this. This is how the formula has been calculated. Now that we know that, you know, FCFE formula, we can start with the calculate the FCFE for 2016. You can see the balance sheet, liability and income statement over here. Based on this, we'll try solving the net income FCFE formula, which we now very well know it because we have understood. Find the net income, which is over here. $168, right? Find the depreciation and amortization, which is the second portion. So that is 150 over here. And then the third thing, the changes in the working capital. So you need to do some calculation based on the changes in the working capital, cash, account receivable, inventory, current assets, and all of the assets, 870 and 630, and same for the liabilities. Once you do the changes in the working capital, you get your capital expenditures. Your capital expenditure is basically change in the gross PPE, which is your data over here, gross PPE 1200 minus 900. And once you do that, you get your capital expenditure. You need to note that the cash impact will be outflow of 300. As you can see that 2016 is 1200 and 17 is 1200 and 16 is 900. That means there is an outflow which has been done. The net borrowings, the short-term, long-term borrowings, as you can see in over here, short-term and long-term borrowings, short-term debt and long-term debt. So the differences will be 60 minus 30, so 30. Borrowing will include the long-term debt is 342 minus 342. So the net borrowing is going to be 30 plus 42. And when we have all the data, you just put in the formula, you get your FCFE, and your FCFE seems to be positive over here, which is 15. This is how you calculate your data for FCFE formula. Remember one thing, you know, there are many other ways also to calculate your FCFE and for calculating for discounting, but this is the best possible fashion you can put things into. Now, what exactly you need to learn is what exactly is your negative FCFE. See, like net income, FCFE can also be negative. And negative FCFE can happen due to any or combination of the factors. Like, you know, company is reporting huge losses. Net income is largely negative over here. Second, you can say that company makes huge capex or the huge capital expenditure resulting in negative FCFE. You can say that changes in the third reason can be changes in the working capital resulting in an outflow, right? And the fourth thing is that debt is repaid resulting in large cash flow. So this can be the reason and behind which the cash flows, the FCFF can be negative. Now, how dividend is different from FCFE? See, you can think of FCFE as the potential dividend. You can think it that way instead of actual dividend. A part of the earning each year may be paid to the shareholders, dividend payout, and remaining amount is retained by the company for the future growth. So dividend depends on the dividend payout ratio, and mature and stable companies do try to follow the stable dividend policy. But FCFE is basically the free cash flow available after all the obligations have been taken care of. Think of the capex, debt, working capital, etc. Second, FCFE starts with the net income, you can say, before the dividends are deducted, and add all the non-cash items like depreciation and amortization. Thereafter, what you need to do is that capital expenditure required for the company's growth is subtracted. In addition, changes in the working capital is also accounted so as to be successfully run the business in operating year. Lastly, the net borrowings can be negative or positive as added. FCFF is therefore is the potential dividends left over after all the stakeholders have been taken care of. Thank you, everyone.